Hello, hello.
Hello, you have the best setup I've seen.
Well, good. At least it's not the worst setup, right?
No, this is great. You've really you've nailed it.
Good, good. I appreciate that. Thank you so much.
The Steve Serrano Show. He talks with your favorite celebrities, gets the exclusive interviews, and never seen before performances. Here's your host, Steve
Serrano. How are you today?
I'm good. Thank you very much. How are you?
I'm very well. Thank you. I saw that you went to a concert last night. How amazing was that show to see Dua?
She is just a force. I couldn't get over it. There was four outfit changes, the choreography. That woman knows how to flip her hair. I'll tell you that. I was living for it. And it was the first show of the whole tour, and it was immaculate. It was great.
And I heard you lost your voice a little bit. Is that because you were singing along and screaming, right?
I don't think singing is the right word. I was more screaming I don't know, but when I see a live show, I do kind of just lose my mind a little bit because I love it so much. And one of my really good friends who plays keys for me sometimes, he is now Dua Lipa's guitarist. So he was on stage shredding it. So I was yeah.
When you go to a show like that, are you going as a fan, or are you going to try to learn things to help you when you perform?
I'm going as a fan always, but then I can't help but I get so inspired. And especially last night, it was just, I left there being I need to I'm going to up my game. And it's not even, not up my game, but I was just it was just amazing to just the choreography and the outfits, and just, it was just so seamless. And I just think it's always great, for performers to watch other performers. And yeah, when you leave, you're just okay, cool. That was amazing.
And then I saw the yellow on yellow. Did she have a yellow on yellow outfit?
She had, she has a all in one.
Okay. I was man, that's it. Yellow on yellow, that you don't see that very often. Look at that, setting the bar.
I know. And she, do you know what? If someone can pull that off, it's Dua,
That's true.
If I wore that, it would be a different, it would not be good, but she can pull it off.
Take me back. I know you started music at 19 years old. Is this right?
I was back.
So what made you finally want to get into music and start writing?
I'd always loved it, and I sort of had written songs when I was a lot younger, and I always loved performing in schools, but I never ever really kind of released anything or thought, this could be my job, as it were, because that just seemed so far away to me. But I think once I reached 19, I was just what are you going to lose by just putting something out there? Nothing bad is going to happen. And just see, just see, because I loved it so much. And I knew that's what I wanted to do. So I just thought, what else are you doing with your life? Nothing. So I took that leap of faith, put us on the SoundCloud, and I'm so glad I did, because now I'm here talking to you.
That's absolutely correct. Now, what do you think you would be doing if you wouldn't have put that on SoundCloud? What would be your job? What do you think?
I would have found a way. I would have found another way to get wriggle myself in.
I love that.
The thing, because I'm actually, I know this might sound like I'm just saying it, but I'm literally not good at anything else. thank God that this is working out, because I have no other talent, nothing.
There's nothing wrong with that. You knew exactly what your talent was, so we had to go for it, right?
Yeah, it kind of had to work, because I honestly don't know what I would have been doing.
So where do you feel the most confident? Do you feel most confident when you're writing, when you're in the studio, or when you're performing on stage?
I think performing on stage, that's my thing. I'm just absolutely in love with it. And I think obviously writing is, it's, obviously amazing, and it's very therapeutic, and I feel very, very grateful to be able to do that. But sometimes that part is kind of like, it's a little draining, which is fine. You know, that's just, it is what it is when you're writing about your emotions all the time. But then when you get great songs that you love, and then when you get to perform them, like, that's the payoff for me, like getting to see people face to face, seeing them enjoy it, enjoy the songs. And yeah, I love it. It's my favorite.
And how about a song that did pay off for you? Better Days. 13 million. Look at this number. 13 million YouTube views. 300 million streams, May. 3.3.5 billion TikTok views. This song is the real deal. This is amazing.
That's kind of crazy.
Right? Like, we'll never see this many people in like an arena, but you know they're out there and they're absorbing your music. This is awesome, especially the song.
Yeah, I know. It's funny when I hear like the numbers and stats, I'm like, because I was speaking about this the other day. It's like those numbers and the statistics, like, they're like people, like real people, like listening and digesting it. So it's always very, very exciting for me to hear that.
I love that. Now, you worked with Polo G, you worked with Naked on this track. Who is somebody that you would love to work on in a future track with? Anybody, doesn't even matter.
There's so many people. I think, right? I would love to work with Doja, but I know that's probably a bit further down the line. But I think me and her would just write something like so bad B, and just, it would just be a banger. But I would also love to write with, I love Julia Michaels, and I've been such a fan of her writing for so long. I think Phineas would be amazing, and just great songwriters. You know, I'd love to just delve deeper, like into that world. And because I love writing, sort of like my music. So I think they're like the powerhouses for me. They're like my songwriting heroes.
I love that. Now, you have so many fans that are currently watching you right now on this. We obviously know that they find you on social media all the time. What would you love to say to the fans that you don't have an opportunity ever to say?
I just want to remind them every single time how much I love them and how thankful I am that they are with me on this, and just to remind them that they're the bosses. Like, you guys are running this ship, like, and they, you know, none of us could do anything without them. So I just want to thank them, and stick with me, because there's a lot more to come and it's going to be a fun ride.
I love that. All right, May, before you leave, I'm going to put you on a hot seat. Are you ready for this?
Okay, I think so.
I think you need a drink, water. You good?
No, it's fine.
All right, let's do this. Hot seat. Favorite junk food. What's May Muller's favorite junk food?
Chick-fil-A.
Ooh, what do you get though?
I get the chicken sandwich with the waffle fries and the little chicken bite things with the Chick-fil-A sauce.
On the side, right? So do you do do you do cheese? Do you do the, like, the deluxe, right? Okay.
The deluxe, like, okay. And cheese, the whole shebang, yeah.
Okay, good, good, good. All right, last thing you do before bed?
Oh, like, I mean, obviously skincare routine, very important. But when I'm actually in bed, like the last time, I'll put on like something lighthearted, like Grace and Frankie, or like listen to a podcast, because it kind of sends me to sleep, and then I go to sleep.
Do you have to have the TV on or not?
I usually, it's probably not the best way to like wind down, but I usually have like something on my laptop or like
something play.
Just something to, I don't like to be with my thoughts when I'm alone.
Let it go.
Yeah. I like to have something, you know, lighthearted in the background.
Okay. All right. How about this? Favorite ice cream flavor. What's your favorite ice cream flavor?
I like chocolate.
Just plain chocolate?
Well, no, if we're going to get like funky with
I might as well.
Cookies and cream.
Okay.
And I just love anything that Ben and Jerry's does. Like, okay. Anything. Okay.
I get that. Dogs or cats? I think I know this answer.
Oh, well, I actually have a cat. So I love cats, but I think at heart, I don't know if this is bad, but I think I'm more of like a dog person.
Okay. There's nothing wrong with that. The cats are self-contained.
I'm batting for both sides at the moment. But yeah, cats, you have to really earn their trust and their love, you know?
That's true. What's your cat's name?
Snorlax.
Wow, okay.
He's quite fat, so that's why.
The best are fat cats. Let's be honest, though, right? You can't go wrong with a fat cat.
It's just more to cuddle. I love it.
All right. How about this? What's your favorite karaoke song?
Probably me and my mom like to do Woman in Love, Barbra Streisand.
Oh, okay. I like that.
I mean, it sounds awful, but it's fun.
It works. All right. What about this? What app do you use the most?
Probably maybe either TikTok or Instagram, something.
One of those two, right?
Down the line, yeah. I could spend hours scrolling on TikTok. It's so dangerous.
Do you even scroll on Facebook anymore? Do you even hop on there?
What's Facebook? No, joking. I go on there to like check on, you know.
You check on things, right? I feel like that's what you do with Facebook now. You just check to see what's going on. I don't know why.
See what the tea is, like what people from my old school are doing from time to time. But yeah, I don't really go on there too much. Sorry, Facebook.
Yeah, no, I'm with you. All right, two more questions for you here. What time is your alarm set for?
Oh, I don't really like to set alarms if I don't have to.
Really? Do you naturally wake up around the same time?
Well, no, I mean, if I have to, see, this is what's bad, actually, because if I let myself sleep, I could just sleep until like mid. I'm not a morning person. I'm sorry. I'm not. But I mean, no, if I have nothing to do, I'll probably set my alarm for like 10, just so I'm not like in bed all day. But yeah, I mean, it's hard because in music, every day is different. So I'm getting up at different times.
Now, let's say you have a call time at 6 a.m. How many, I know that's brutal, right? But let's say you have a call time. How many times would you have to set the alarm? Just one time or multiple alarms?
I'll set like 4 alarms.
Okay, good. I tell you, mate, you can't trust anybody that can just do one alarm and wake up. There's no possible way.
No, Mogul, that's not normal.
No, I've only met one artist that does that. And I feel like I can't trust her. I really don't.
Yeah, I feel like that's like a bit of that's kind of like a superpower. I don't know how people would do that. Some people are just, they just wake up and they're like ready to go. I wish I was more like that, but no, it takes a lot for me to get out of bed, especially early in the morning.
All right, one more question. Who's your best friend?
Who's my best friend? You are.
May Moeller, Better Days. You've got to check out her single. Let's boost these. Right now, we've got 13 million on YouTube, 300 million streams, 3.3 billion TikTok views. We're excited. Hopefully, we'll bring you here to Kansas City very soon. May Moeller, thank you so much for the time.
Thank you so much. Yeah, that was fun.
Again, thank you guys so much for checking out our interview today with May Moeller. It would mean so much to us if you would like, subscribe, and tell a friend about the show. Until next time, I'm Steve Serrano. Thanks for watching.